So far, we've learned that you can get good answers in calculus by doing approximations and better approximations and better approximations. That was our first pillar. Close is good enough. Then the second big idea was that you can track the changes in a function by taking a limit of the average rate of change over shorter and shorter and shorter and shorter periods of time. The third big idea is what I call what goes up has to stop before it has to stop before it comes down. So let's just take a ball and throw it in the air. Go ahead. If you track its height as a function of time, you'll probably get something like that. And the question is, at the top of the arc, how fast is it rising? Well, if it were rising at a positive rate, if it were heading up, then an instant later, it would have been higher. That doesn't make sense, because it's the top. And if it were heading down, then an instant earlier, it would have been higher. And that doesn't make sense, because it's the top. So at the top, the rate of change is zero. It can't be positive and it can't be negative, so it's got to be zero. Actually, there's a slight exception. The slight exception is that it might not exist. If you had something that bounces instantly off the ceiling, then at the top, it doesn't have a rate of change. And there's one more exception, which is that it could keep going up for as long as you watch. You're only paying attention to it for 2 seconds, and during those 2 seconds, it kept on going up and up and up and up. And then the maximum would be at an endpoint. But that's not really what we're talking about for the top of the arc. Most of the time, we're talking about smooth things where the derivative exists, and we're talking about things where you're looking over the whole interval, and when you've got a maximum, the derivative's got to be zero. So let's write that down. At a maximum, or a minimum, the same thing would apply to the bottom of the arc. Either the derivative is zero, or the derivative does not exist, or you're at an endpoint. And usually, we're not interested in places where it doesn't exist. Usually, we're not interested in endpoints. Usually, the way to find a maximum is to take a derivative and set it equal to zero. In fact, this is where the name calculus came from. Leibniz wrote a paper that was talking about this great new method for finding areas and slopes and this, that, and the other that without recourse to this, that, or the other thing. The method is the calculus for doing this. So, all sorts of optimization problems in the real world, what's the best way to do something, or what's the worst way to do something, take a derivative, set it equal to zero.